Thomas the Tank Engine and Friends, Wooden Railway Adventures, Episode 229, Marion Had a Little Lamb. The Sodor China Clay Works had been temporarily closed due to heavy rains, and the engines that worked there were suddenly without a job. "Oh, whatever will we do?" cried Timothy. "I've never worked anywhere outside of the clay pits before. Do you think Sir Topham Hatt will send me away?"
"Nonsense," said Boko. "There are plenty of jobs for you on this railway. I hear there's an opening at the chocolate factory, if anyone's interested."
Timothy and Gator looked at each other and raced away. Bill and Ben, on the other hand, were in no such rush.
"Yay! No work for us! We'll get to play in the yard all day!"
"Ooh! Maybe we should go bug Edward at Wellsworth. Care to join us, Boko? It'll be just like old times."
"No, thank you," he chuckled. "Run along, you troublemakers. You're not my problem now."
Marion, on the other hand, was rather distraught.
"Timothy's right. The Sodor China Clay Works is the only place I know of. It will be hard for me to fit in somewhere else, since I'm such a specialized engine."
"Well, you could always go to the docks. It's a very busy place, and they need all the help they can get."
"I suppose," she murmured, "I guess I can't throw the cargo around like I do the rocks at my old job, right?"
"No, please don't do that. Salty will never forget it."
Just then, Harvey puffed up.
"I spent some time at the docks not too long ago, Marion, and while I wouldn't consider it to be my forever job, it was a nice change of pace to what I was used to. You should give it a shot."
Marion smiled.
"All right, I'll do it. First thing tomorrow morning, I'll go down to the docks and see how I can help."
True to her word, Marion arrived at the docks the next day.
"Boko wasn't kidding," she murmured. "It's pure chaos here."
"We've got multiple ships coming in," grunted Cranky.
"Arthur, I need those trucks moved out of the way. Porter, clear the siding at once. And where are those delivery trucks? They should be here by now. We can't keep holding these packages until they decide to show up. You, down there! Get Crosby on the telephone and tell them if they aren't here in 15 minutes, I'm throwing everything overboard."
"Oh, hello, Marion. Sorry I can't stay and chat, but it's a little crazy right now. We're missing valuable storage space since one of our piers got destroyed."
"Yes, I can see that. Is there anything I can do to help?"
Well, Farmer McColl has some new livestock that just came in. Would you be willing to take it to him on Thomas's branch line?"
"Yes, of course. That sounds like a fun time."
"Great. It's that truck right over there. Good luck."
Marion was excited.
"Oh boy, my first job outside of the quarry. Well, hello there, friend. Aren't you the cutest little lamb? You're so adorable. We are going to have so much fun together."
"Marion," shouted Salty, "we need to use that track. Can you move the lamb and yourself, please?"
"Oh, yes, sir, Salty," she spluttered.
"Oh, I've never pulled a train before. This is very weird. All right, we're off. See you, Cranky. Bye, Salty."
And Marion puffed away with her delivery. She was very proud of her new job.
"Hello, Timothy. Greetings, Gator. Are you both enjoying your new life at Mr. Jolly's Chocolate Factory?"
"Enjoying might be a bit of a stretch," said Gator. "It's very different from the clay pits, that's for sure."
"Hey, watch it! You about hit me off the track!"
"Oh, sorry, Gator. I'm not used to working in such a confined space."
"Well, you guys have fun. I'm taking this cute little lamb up to Farmer McColl's farm."
"Wow, that's so cool! Where is Farmer McColl's farm, anyway?"
Marion chuckled.
"It's on Thomas's branch line, didn't you know?"
"Very interesting," added Timothy. "How do you even get to Thomas's branch line?"
"Oh, you know, you go up the line and make a right, I think. And yeah, keep puffing until you see the farm, I'm guessing."
"Marion, are you sure you know where to go?"
"Of course I do, Gator. I have everything under control."
Speaking of which, your lamb has escaped, giggled Timothy. Marion gasped and looked around. The lamb had wandered onto a nearby runway. How did you get out of your truck, silly little lamb? You had me scared there for a second. Marion's driver ushered the lamb back into the car. Well, I must be going. Farmer McColl's farm is very, very far away. At least, I think it is. Anyway, see you guys around. And Marion was off. Unfortunately, she had never worked anywhere besides the China Clay Company, and Marion's unfamiliarity with Sodor started to show. Well, I thought I was headed in the right direction, but this looks like the steamworks, and this is the cement works. Excuse me, Patrick, is Farmer McColl's farm around here? Patrick laughed. Oh no, Marion, that's on the other side of the island. Oh, bother! And here I thought I was making progress. Come along, let's go. Hey, get back here! The cement works is no place to play around in. That's quite the curious little lamb, chuckled Patrick. Better keep an eye on her. Yes, indeed. If you keep this up, I'm not going to have anything to deliver to Farmer McColl, if I somehow make it there. But the trouble wouldn't stop. Marion tried her best, but she kept getting lost. Maybe I can see Farmer McColl's farm from way up here, she said. Okay, there's the cement works. I've already been there. There's the iron works. Ooh, looks hot. There's the lamb. The lamb? My lamb! How did you get down there? Come back! And Marion raced away. Fortunately, the Sodor Railway Repair came by and made sure the lamb didn't wander any further. An overturned boat is not a playground, she grumbled. Come along, we need to get you to your new home as soon as possible. But Marion still didn't have any luck. There's the airport again, and this must be the Blue Mountain Quarry. Oh, I am so lost, and with the sun beginning to set, there's no way I'm going to be able to find Farmer McColl's farm in the dark. Farmer McColl? Asked Mighty. You're looking for his farm? Well, I've got some great news for you. Really? Gasped Marion. Yes, you're not too far away, said Mac. Just follow this line through Natford, and you'll get there really quick. Oh, thank you so much. Wow, the Blue Mountain Quarry is impressive. Those tall cliffs are... Oh my, that's my lamb. What is she doing up there? Get back down here. Don't be afraid, said Scarlowe softly. Let's get you down on the ground where you belong. It took some gentle prodding, but eventually, Marion's lamb trotted down the incline and hopped back into the car. I can't thank you little engines enough, she said wearily. It's been a long day. And Marion puffed away. With sunlight rapidly fading, Marion followed Mighty Mac's directions, and at last, she finally arrived at Farmer McColl's farm. Hello, sir! We did it! Hooray! Wait, are you still back there? Oh, phew! It would have been just my luck if I'd arrived late and tired with no lamb in tow. Farmer McColl will not believe what I've been through today. Sir Topham Hatt laughed. Your story will have to wait another time, Marion. Farmer McColl was so worried about you and his lamb that he went to the docks to look for you both. I promised him I would stay here and keep watch in case you arrived. And, well, here you are. You're several hours late, of course, but you made it here in the end, and that's all that matters. Marion smiled. Thank you, sir. As much fun as today was, I can't wait to get back to the clay pits. I don't think animals are really my thing. They are too unpredictable, and they run away. Now rocks don't run away. They stay where you put them, and I like that. This lamb, on the other hand... Marion gasped. She had escaped again. Look over there. The lamb's just fine. Already taking a liking to Farmer McColl's farm, it appears. Just what we like to see. Marion breathed a sigh of relief. She was going to sleep very well tonight.